heavens. I shall keep it here.
Satisfied and safe to receive me.
And that time will be never.
Mr. Walker knows me. I'm his friend.
Try that pestilent pond where they sank his car.
I've been there.
Try that cemetery where he buried his Sarah like a queen.
I've been there, too.
Then try the gates of justice where they're deaf to his misery and anger.
I understand how you feel.
Across that sky now, Sarah.
said no music.
He's here.
Bring him in. What is it you want? Turn and this affair is forgotten, we'll find a suitable place for the child, and everything will be like it was.
Things will never be the same.
I meant the same as before, when we were happy.
I will not
give up the child to anyone except Mr. Walker.
I love him.
Be safe.
Everything will be fine.
Thank you. things, my people.
We're all Kohats.
Every one of our race with a faulty heart costs us one more piece of land.
We want justice.
What has your selfish recklessness cost us? We who worked so hard to steal the white man's hate.
My anger is too great.
Monstrous man, look what you've done.
Despite the respect I have for you, Mr. Washington, you have come in vain.
Had you been ignorant of the tragic struggle of our people, I could have pitied you this adventure. But you're a trained musician, an educated man.
That is true, sir. But I hope that might suggest to you that miscalculation of my mind. We are both men of colors who insist on the truth of our manhood and the respect it demands.
Love is matching by color, shadows 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 matching by color.
Your situation is hopeless, and you will be responsible for the death of these young men.
Don't listen to him, David. Using him to get to you.
We're not giving up.
And you dare to teach your lessons to these wild, unthinking youths. Yet your own son you abandon to be raised on white men's truths. Look what you've done. Think of your son. Is this the legacy you would bestow upon him? Are these the shoulders you would have him stand upon? Let him be the son of a man who had the courage to tell the truth in a court of law. Make your case, and if the verdict be death, go to it proudly, knowing that you've been heard. The truth is all. If you do this, you will have the thanks and respect of every decent man of color, and of all those children of our race, whose way is hard and whose journey is long. Think of your son.
I need a hostage and safe passage for my men.
It is done.
You can't change your demands. You are betraying us! You said we would all go free, or we all would die.
And the promise of a fair trial.
No!
You have my word. I am their mediator, sir, not their fool.
Then they will see me come out with my hands raised. And no further harm will come to any man. From Cold House Walker, Jr.
We're not going.
You lost, Cold House. We've all lost.
I don't believe that. Are they going to kill me?
Of course not. They're decent men. I would not have come here if I did not believe that.
Mr. Walker, your men have gone. Will you come out now?
Thank you for your kindness to my family. You're welcome.
He's a fine boy. After Cole House Walker's death, younger brother drove south to Mexico, where he joined the great peasant revolutionary Emiliano Zapata.
The signs of the coming world war were everywhere. The anarchist Emma Goldman was arrested again, of course. But this time she would be deported as well.
Booker T. Washington's Tuskegee Institute became in time the center of Black America. When he died, flags were flown at half-mast. President and Mrs. Wilson attended his funeral.
I will show him a merry mind.
breathtaking new musical, Ragtime, the number one theatrical event of the year. 4 out of 4 stars. A major American musical, a sensational production. The last great musical of the century. Ragtime at the Ford Center for the Performing Arts. Call 212-307-4550.
Ever since I heard there'd be a big Broadway musical version of E.L. Doctorow's book, Ragtime, I doubted it could be done. The story is too sweeping. There are too many characters and historical events to depict. Everybody had seen the movie, and it would be logistically impossible. Well, those problems were faced and conquered superbly. The setting is the turn of the century, when ragtime music ruled the roost, and New York had already become the cultural and commercial center of a country still feeling its growing pains. And you're immediately thrust into the tempos of the times, as ragtime pianist Colehouse Walker Jr., played sensationally by Brian Stokes Mitchell, does a bit of the getting ready rag. Now, Colehouse is reunited with his lover, Audra McDonald, and their newborn son before racism leads to tragedy in their lives. In this musical, which takes the time to let its characters grow and evolve and effectively matches them with actors who understand the people they're portraying. It's not coincidental that they've inserted a scene with Henry Ford urging his workers on, since, after all, this is being performed at the Ford Center, and the logo appears on the program.
What are the people saying?
Maren Mazzie is enchanting as the mother who takes pity on Colehouse and his family. Lynette Perry is perfectly cast as Evelyn Nesbitt, the girl in the red velvet swing. And Peter Friedman's compelling as a Jewish immigrant widower father with grand dreams. And even though the songs by Stephen Flaherty and Lynn Ahrens all sound like finale numbers, they're inspiring. Frank Galati's direction is impeccable, skillfully orchestrating a cast of almost 50, plus a functioning Model A Ford, a train, boats, riots, a dazzling Houdini escape trick, and it makes a 3 hour seem like 10 minutes. This is nothing short of a full-fledged triumph. It's an evening of theater to be cherished. I'm Jeffrey Lyons, News Channel 4.